better, face to face.
Yeah, I
do the cypher. I do the cypher, face to face. The cypher is must. Everyone a dope rapper till I come after.
Yeah.
Till I rap after.
Yeah.
All right. Love me all the time.
And backwards. Now my hair on Jimi Hendrix, I can fold it backwards. But you know what? We got that enigma. Hey, no progress. Some things I couldn't digest. Hey, yeah. But she's fine every time. But she's fine every time. And I don't want to take time. Cause times like this come now and then. And I'm just glad you. Cause last time I made you cry again, 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 I'm sorry.
Yeah, sample the shit on 80s. Like the drums and shit, we edit the drums ourselves, but like the main sample, let me sign the shit on 80s. It'll be easier. Like the main sample, like we chopped it up, me and Francis.
Oh, like the vinyl crackle.
Vision first, a couple rappers tend to singers, a couple singers tend to write a verse. I'm not in the bracket, ayy. Swear to God, I'll get these commas. Call up the plug, I need power. My niggas, they young and in power. My kids on the fifth baby shower. I'm slowly adapting, ayy. I do this for the passion, ayy. She ain't fuck with the caption, but yeah, she be laughing. She looked at me once, it's enough to address it. I ask where she stay when I'm caught up in traffic. I came with the lights, now it's camera action. She smell like a shimmy. You drove fast, can you see me?
This record's lay next to my heart on the floor. Stay afloat with me, I usually can't sleep when I'm sore. I found a gap between time, I found a gap between time. Let's start, let's break it off. All this record's lay next to my heart on the floor. Stay afloat with me, I usually can't sleep when I'm sore. I found a gap between time, I found a gap between time. Let's start, let's break it off.
Music shit starting to stick with the fan. There's no more telling me it wasn't a plan. There's no more asking for the whip cause I can. Keep your hustle.
Yeah, simple Shaka Khan got to be there. Like, what was the vibes when we made this beat? Where's your place or what?
Yeah, where my place? It was just like, yeah, looking, just trying to make a dope beat. You know, like when you have a couple songs already out for the tape, but then you're like, oh.
Trying to catch up. Yeah, trying to fill up.
Yeah.
But it's worked out, yeah. Especially the flow is like heavy. So you wrote that day as well, or?
I don't think I wrote that day. I think I did something else. But yeah, I just wrote like
a couple bars,
and then from there, it was like, cause for me the production of the drums, just like how the progression of it, yeah, it kind of showed me how to flow as well.
Yeah, the first part in Love Me though, this shit. I actually didn't sample anything like
there.
Like on the record. Yeah, this is like skip tracing shit. About it.
Me, it wasn't a plan. It's not my asking for the whip cause I can. Keep your hustle, expand. She's scrolling through, now she says she a fan. Moving fast, you can chop if you can. You catch up if you can. I'm holding my bars, you holding it down. I know you don't know how I feel when I move. Wish I could just keep it 100 with you. You and I wanna share something, but that's the fake, it'll ruin us. I hope you find someone new who does. You still my friend like you always were.
It was off the internet and stuff.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Yeah, but it that's okay, Looney man, this shit fucking hot. I sampled a bunch of songs from this shit, basically. I sampled a bunch of shit from this, bro. This shit's hot. Yeah, Balcony.
Yo. Let's go. Let's have this bleach. Come through.
I could never stop being me now. You should've known by now that we gel great. I never really liked all these broads. Just stayed inside, bumped every eye. Every time they look at me different. Every time they look at a distance. I keep telling myself, keep on telling myself. But it's okay, I guess. We could all have a throwback. Time will pass the pain away. I know time will make this all okay. And it's all the same topics when we get to jail. Times like this when I am alone. Too much emotion. It's times like this where I feel like a bro on my own. It's times like this where I feel like a bro. It's times like this where I feel like a bro on my own. Or maybe you say I show too much emotion. It's
times like... Did I get ready to start flexing?
Yeah, we need to check ourselves. I was going through the money.
Sorry, bro, I recut.
Later, don't bump me like that. Yeah. He did a gay kind of thing.
Yeah, bro, I don't feel that.
What are you waiting for, bro? You don't know what's up.
You guys are just steady fashion.
I thought you said it's just two people,
bro. Yeah, you can't tell me it's like CD or some shit. Stay up late.
What the fuck, man? Seven people.
It's not a party.
Because there's already people.
No, like, not coming in.
It's funny we met by a taco stand. All the two tacos I could not comprehend. While we wait on our orders, you got a man. Had to take it from young, but then again, most probably suited like wedding plans. And it's obvious that I'm just standing in, but we standing out. I tasted you once, can you hear me out? If I'm catching the camera.
How long did it take you to mix and master the entire project?
Oh wow. Per song, yeah. I can answer per song, but I cannot say, can probably calculate it. So roughly around, like, it took me like, if I really, there's some, like, during the beginning stages, I usually spend more time on the mixing and mastering. So that would probably be like 4 hours on mixing and mastering. And then it, like, towards the end, like, because of the time and the time factor, I had to like really speed up the thing. So I basically didn't spend a lot of time in unnecessary things. So that probably brought me up to like 3 hours per mix. So an hour less on the other mixes. So roughly I'd say like an entire day, 24 hours.
But like the whole project though?
The whole project, how many tracks is it?
13.
Yeah, that's like just roughly like 3 hours a mix. That's how much. Yeah, that's quite a lot. So that's the amount of hours. Yo, that's a lot of hours, dude. Yeah, but it's cool. Like, I really liked it because it was even new to me. Like, because I had to mix the beats. The beats were mixed separately. And so, wait. That's a lot more hours then.
Because the
beats were mixed separately. And then the final mix took around like 3 hours. But like the beats, like roughly an hour or two. Because I mean, like, most of the stuff already like laid out perfectly.
Yeah, like, and just imagine, because like when it comes to artists, some artists don't know how technical the mix and mastering process is, you know, and they put pressure on the master engineer to like, yo man, we need the product now, but like it's halfway done and all that shit.
Yeah.
Did the peacemakers put any pressure on you?
No, these guys were like so chilled, man. They were so cool, man. Like, I like working with them, man. That's why I also say I'll put in more time when it's planned ahead. Mm. When a project is like really planned ahead and then we can work properly. I'll appreciate that more.
Yeah, because like, you know, also just when it came to him, it was like most of the lyrics were done, you know, most of the songs were like done and stuff, so it was just like placement for focus. Yeah,
like these guys, like every time they came they were prepared. There wasn't a lot of time wasted with the recordings. I mean, there were days where we recorded like 3 tracks in like 2 hours, and like all I had to do was just sit down and do the mixing. But like That was like really dope. Like, we really organized this whole thing properly. We started with recordings only, and I mixed some tracks in my free time and stuff. And then we all just like did them, like we sat down on the listening. Every time I had a mix down, we sat down for a listening, and then they would record. So it was just like it was really properly organized, like really, really professional. I liked it. Yeah.
What gave you the idea for the cover art? Like, I know you're into photography. You've been doing it for like a couple of years now. Mm-hmm. And
no,
like,
I mean just over a year, sorry.
Just over a year, Nate. Yeah. Oh yeah, you started just last year.
Yeah, at the beginning of last year.
Like you direct a lot of your own shoots.
Yeah.
So like obviously I'm sure it, like the cover art must have been inspired by something, you know. Was it after you heard the project, like while they were making it and they gave you like a sample of the project, did that kind of give you a vision as to how the cover art should look, or was it just a total new idea, that like an image that you wanted to bring to the piece of work?
Mm. No, I think that it's a very, I mean, when it comes to a creative process, it's very difficult to kind of like remove the bass from reggae. So it's kind of like, things are just happening, you know. But first I start with the music. I think I ask for the music first, and that's where I start. So I'll get like an idea, sonic idea of, you know, where I'm seeing. So I could never do a Peacemaker cover for someone else. You know, it was just something that was suited for them in that space-time continuum. So it was not something that could be repeated. You know? Yeah, so the music, getting stimulation from the music, seeing the vinyls. So when I was looking at the vinyls, my mind is already like, you know, going on a different adventure of seeing the vinyls tiled. I didn't tell them at the time, I think. And then I came a few days later because I just wanted to keep the idea still a bit fresh. And then I was just kind of developing it in my mind and seeing it. Then I was like, okay, I asked my sister to get me some lab coats from a friend. And then I got a few props, but I used them minimalistically to just kind of help bring it to life. And we just used natural light, which is dope. So everything's just kind of art, everything's just kind of moved away from like, oh, you're singing in an off note. It's kind of like, oh, what is it you want to express? So that's how it came together. So yeah, it's just a very unique space and time continuum. So something I think about, just, you know, it's just happening.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. On the album, which track stood out to you the most and why?
So I think it's something, it's a project that I still need to explore even further. I think it's very multi-layered. I was just talking about their writing and I was just like, it's actually, it's out of this world actually. As a writer, I don't think I would, I don't know what feelings they're feeling, but I don't think that I'll be able to write like that. I'll be able to maybe write something that is a part of that truth, maybe a different tunnel, a different perspective to their truth, but their writing style is very unique. So, and Sunny's doing most of the lyrics, so, and then Wasabi's mostly on the production, and you hear that, so, yeah, which is cool. So they have that balance.
Nice.
Fantastic. Yeah, like how long did it take you guys to complete the album and what was the inspiration, like what was it based off?
Took us like a couple of months just to
seven,
like,
to be exact.
Yeah, took us like a couple months just to get everything in the bag, you know. But it was basically inspired by, should I say, heartbreak, relationships, all that, like,
yeah.
Yeah,
it was inspired by, like, I'd say, like female energy, but trying to convey this message with like life, you know. Just all these things that were happening at this certain time in our lives helped us like create the tape, you know. It's like,
and if I'm not mistaken, you guys wanted to drop, was it Milkway Spain, or because it was off different energies, like why did you guys decide like, yo, it's gonna be Love Me and My Bad Days, this is the concept, you know?
Alcoy Spain was like always something we wanted to do, you know, and include like a whole flight school, like a, it was more like a, how should I say it, like growth from flight school, you know. But then when we had a lot of ideas before we came to Love Me, so Love Me was just like, yeah, it was off the experience we were going through that time, so yeah. Alcoy Spain couldn't be done then because we had to address that emotion.
Yeah, it was like, Love Me on My Babies was like, it was something we had to do at that point in time. It was like, yeah, Love Me on My Babies, Alcoy Spain is like in the future now, but Love Me on My Babies is the present moment.
Okay, and yeah, I just wanted to ask, based off the headspace now with the writing and whatnot, because from my understanding or when I listen to the tape, what I feel it's like more so of a motivational tape, kind of like it puts you in the mood, man. Just like off the first track already, like waking up early morning, that's already like, you know. So that headspace, was it like as you're writing, were you like, yo, like this first day is, it's the start, man, like opening the tape and all that
energy and
energy
everything
for it? Yeah, just that headspace, man, when writing, like,
like we said, definitely was, it was, we're coming from a place where it's like, you know, it's like, it's not depression, but it's also like, let me say, you are lonely and you're going through certain things. So it's like self-thought. So it was a lot of like self-reflection at the time.
So it was more so like of a isolation.
Yeah, like, isolation.
Like around the time you're doing the tape, you're like
isolated. Yeah. Yeah. Basically not going out, not hanging a lot, just in the room, making the beats, writing the lyrics. That was the headspace we're in, like just cutting off from everything else to create this vibe. And then,
and that took like 7 months.
That took like 7 months, bro.
But you know, like as far as, just to address what you're asking, the writing, even like first day, the song, you know, we're looking for, when people like start off the album, they're already like captured.
Yeah.
Even just by the sound and the knock of everything. So I wasn't really thinking about what I was saying when I was like waking up early morning, I'm focused. I was still in that isolation process, but for like people to actually say like, yo, this is like motivation.
For it to come up as motivation while you're not,
yeah, while I wasn't, yeah, I was just like, dude, yeah. So
it's just a day to day, that's how you'd wake up, that's
how you move. Exactly.
And yeah, off the tape, like it's really cohesive, man, from the first track to the second, like it's, I find it hard for an artist like to, you know, do a project that sounds the same, you know, because it kind of has to be different.
Yeah, but it has to,
it has sound to have like a theme.
Yeah.
It beat with the album art, the sonics, the content and whatnot. So like, was it really hard you deciding, like from a producer's point of view, like this beat sounded like this, this beat has to sound like this?
Yeah.
Or was it more so of spontaneous?
You know, it, I would say it's all three, or it's like everything in one, because like during the creative process, like, you know, okay, I'm going for this kind of vibe, but then you wouldn't be able to make that same beat again or that same sound. So everything is just like, it's just a collage, bruh. It's just, they're all different, but they fit that one space.
Yeah.
It makes sense.
After dropping the tape, though, because obviously you guys have been in the game, like, for what?
I mean, like, 4 years
four
now?
4 years.
Yeah.
The reception, how was it different from all the other three tapes you dropped? How was that reception?
The reception...
What changed? The critics and whatnot, like, how was that energy, man?
Yeah. I feel like the reception was and still is crazy. Like our other tapes, the downfall of those tapes was, I would say, our naiveness and the mixing. Like, we're not aware of certain things that we needed to achieve first to put out like a proper record. Even though these EPs and stuff, they put us to where we got to.
Yeah.
Yeah, the reception was crazy. Like, young people say, like, the production, you know, the production is sick. And I handle most of the production. It feels good to, like, actually, like, see the people, like, they actually fuck with stuff that's raw and new. But at the same time, we dig so much and take from the old. So it's like a blend of the old and the now to create, like, the future.
Yeah.
In some sense. So,
and, yeah, off the production, like you said, like, We started producing with GarageBand, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, started producing GarageBand.
So when you listen to that, like, Flight School, and you're listening to Peacemakers, can you see your growth? I mean, you're listening to Love Me and My Bad Days. Can you, like, see your growth that, like, yo, now I understand how to do this beat? Just that entire growth within that, can you, like, see within your music? Can you, like, play Flight School and say, like, yo, this is whack, bruh?
Yeah, I can actually... I can actually, like, look back at... There are certain beats on Flight School where I'm like, shit, I can actually make that beat now.
Oh.
You know, but there are some things where I'm like, nah, what...
What was I doing?
What was I doing at the time? It's like, you know, you get to critique yourself based off your achievements and stuff. But during that time, probably you thought it was the hardest shit.
That's what we thought. You know, the hardest shit. You're like, yo, we're dropping the hardest shit, bruh. You know,
for me, all these things, like, mixing it better, writing better hooks, writing better verses, spending time on the art, it all led to a better reception and a better, like, critique of the album. Even though there are some people who are like, yo, you guys should work more on your vocals, or should work more on, like, your cadences and stuff. I feel like that's the reason why Love Me On My Bad Days is, like, a masterpiece, or it's classic, because of that rawness, bruh, in what we're doing. It's not perfect. You know, it's not perfect.
And I see you guys constantly using this phrase, like, blessed are the peacemakers. See?
Yeah.
So what is the peacemakers more than the music, or is the peacemakers defined by the music?
It's more than the music.
How much impact do you think you're gonna give, or how big are you planning to grow? Like, who are the peacemakers? What do you want to achieve? What impact do you want to give off, like, locally now? You see, because obviously, you know, your sound is different from most of the local music.
Yeah.
But sound being different, that won't really get you far. How many niggas say that? No, I'm the hardest and whatnot. So how do you think you're different, and how do you plan on making a bigger impact than the other niggas?
This bitch is undressing herself here. But yeah. What the fuck?
Yeah.
What was the question, man? I'm sorry, man. I got distracted by that.
But yeah.
She's legit undressing, bro.
Yeah, how big are the peacemakers beyond the music?
Yeah, like, is it more than the music?
I think we are culture, bruh. We are culture. We are part of what's gonna be, like, new. Music-wise, the way we dress, the way we talk, the way we look, the stuff that we're into, I think it's all a part of the next generation of culture that's gonna come through.
Because it's all about, like, being free, man, and, like, having people, like, resonate with your energy. Like, if you look back to Odd Future, like, those are, like, crazy kids, bro, just, like, doing music and, like, having fun, but people, like, found that shit dope. Was like, I can relate to this, even though these guys are, like, doing some dumb shit. It's like, so for us, it's like, we're being free in terms of, like, we're doing this.
Yeah.
Like, peacemakers, it's a culture, it's a vibe, it's an energy.
So do you guys feel like you are the start of a new culture? Like, you guys found your pocket already? Or do you feel like that's still to come?
I feel like it's already happening. It's already happening. It's just, when it happens, it's gonna be obviously on a wider scale, and that's when people will say, oh, it finally happened.
Yeah.
But it's already going down right now as we speak.
So of your life, you can already see it. It's just
going down.
It didn't yet reach the masses.
Yeah, it's not in their faces yet.
It's like you're finding the pocket, you're growing.
You're growing from that. Yeah. So you already found the pocket.
It's like, you know,
we're
how you are
spending
it
now. Just like how we're talking about when we start hosting our own events, the music that's gonna be played at that event. That's the start of culture, you know.
Just make a vibe.
Check. That's how the culture starts.
But we from a small town that limits your self-esteem. I got major dreams.